Welcome back. Let's take you to some breaking news of a major legal blow for former President Donald Trump now. A US court ruling he can be put on trial for attempting to overturn the 2020 election.
US correspondent Alison Petrowski is in Washington, D.C. following that story. Ali, good morning to you. Another setback for the former president.
Yeah, a big setback, guys. Good morning to you. A direct and unanimous decision from the three justices of the DC Court of Appeals here rejecting Donald Trump's claim that a president should have absolute immunity for things that a president does in office. A 57-page ruling handed down a couple of hours ago, and I think this statement from them sums it up. Former President Trump has become Citizen Trump with all of the defences of any other criminal defendant. They go on to dismiss Trump's claim of immunity as irrational because essentially it would mean that anyone who is Commander-in-Chief could commit a whole range of crimes. Not surprisingly, Donald Trump's team has hit back in a statement a short time ago. They say if immunity is not granted to a president, every future president who leaves office will be immediately indicted by the opposing party. So look, Trump must be tried for his alleged attempts to overturn the 2020 election. That is the result of today. He's already pleaded not guilty to those four felony counts. And guys, this trial was originally meant to take place in about 6 weeks from now, in early March here in Washington, D.C. That had been put on ice pending the appeal. Jack Smith, the special prosecutor, and his team were fearful that maybe it wouldn't happen before the election. Today's appeals ruling essentially changes this. It opens up the door for this trial to happen in a matter of months. And guys, it is the one that Donald Trump is the most concerned about. They are very serious charges. And if he's found guilty by a jury of his peers, he could face significant jail time.
All right, Ali, thank you.